Have you ever found, given, or received the perfect Christmas gift? I know it drives us crazy, and for many of us, it's the source of great anxiety as we try to figure out what that perfect gift would be. Just someone that you are so wanting to impress, hopefully because you love them so much and not because it's your boss or something like that. But you just see something and you know it's the perfect gift. My wife and I joke that my sister Helen, if we could find the perfect gift, I know what it would be. It would be some mechanical doll or animal that would probably blow bubbles and be holiday themed. A reindeer blowing bubbles, a Santa blowing bubbles. That would be the perfect gift, it would seem, for her, as she so delights in those. And so do we when we gather for Christmas at her house. But my kids are always asking me, Dad, what would you like for Christmas? And the last couple of years, I've been able to share with them. It's a little different this year. But the last couple of years, I shared with them what I thought the perfect gift would be. And that was the gift of their time. I don't need any more shirts or sweaters or socks or neckties. I don't need gadgets around the house. And those things that I do want, if I can afford them, I buy them for myself throughout the year. So what could be better than to spend time with them? That would make me happy. And my children have responded wonderfully. The last couple of years, my daughter would take me when I was out in Denver, take me to an Avalanche game or take me to some event that we could share in together, me and her husband, and now with my granddaughter. Nothing makes me happier. And for my son, the last couple of years, he's taken me to a Sixers game. And what a delight to just get to spend a day with him. Going to the ball game, just spending time together in the car, having a meal together. It exceeds any physical, any material gift that I could imagine being given. So I got to thinking, if we're looking for the perfect gift, what would Jesus's perfect gift be? What do you give a baby in a manger? What do you give the Son of God? Well, it just so happens that Jesus tells us exactly what he would like us to give. And it's found in one of the most influential verses, passages of scripture for me in my life. I've shared it with you many times, and you've heard it this past Advent, but let me share with you again from the 25th chapter of Matthew, starting at verse 31. Jesus tells this story. When the Son of Man, Jesus, comes as king and all the angels with him, he will sit on his royal throne and the people of all the nations will be gathered before him. Then he will divide them into two groups, just as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. He will put the righteous people at his right and the others at his left. Then the king will say to the people on his right, "Come you that are blessed by my Father. Come you that are blessed by my Father. Come and possess the kingdom which has been prepared for you since the creation of the world. I was hungry and you fed me, thirsty and you gave me a drink. I was a stranger and you received me in your homes, naked and you clothed me. I was sick and you took care of me, in prison and you visited me." And then in verse 37, the righteous will then answer him, "Lord, when did we ever see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you a drink? When did we ever see you a stranger and welcome you in our homes, or naked and clothe you? When did we ever see you sick or in prison and visit you?" Matthew 25, verse 40 says, "The king, our Lord Jesus, will reply, 'I tell you, whenever you did it for one of the least of these followers of mine, you did it for me.'" You want to know what Jesus wants us to do? What the perfect gift would be for our Lord Jesus Christ this Christmas? We're taking up a Christmas miracle offering this year. It's our 9th year to do this. And it's a miracle for a couple of reasons. One is we know that we couldn't do it without God's miraculous intervention. And two, we as a church have made the commitment way back in 2012 and have lived by that commitment every year since. to give whatever it is that we receive in the Christmas offering, to give it all away, to give it to our partners in ministry, to invest every penny, every dollar in life-changing ministries. We give it to those ministries that fulfill the perfect wish list of Jesus, feeding the hungry, sheltering the homeless, clothing the naked, caring for those who are strangers or foreigners or immigrants, lifting up in ministry those who are ill or alone or in prison. It's been a wonderful experience, a joyful ride, if you will, these past 8 years to receive almost $600,000, none of which have been maintained by our church for administrative purposes. None of it pays my salary. None of it keeps the lights on at church. We receive it and we give it, we invest it and we use it in Jesus' name and for God's glory. Friends, if you want to be a part of something bigger than yourself, if you want to be a part of giving the perfect gift to Jesus, I invite you to check us out on our app or on our website, westlawnumc.org, and consider participating, sharing with us, sharing with others through us in the Christmas miracle offering. It is what Jesus has asked for. And so humbly and joyfully, we give it all to God. Friends, may you know the joy and the peace of finding and giving that perfect gift this Christmas. And may God be with you till we meet again.